that the local paper, Tub?
Yes. Just have a quick look through. Girl attacked in park. All local sport. Rock and roll, riots at town hall. Mayor bound over. Dr. A.H. Springle, chief hygiene officer, dies of food poisoning. Riot at Darby and Joan Whist Drive. Henry Sprague, 87, accused of causing bodily harm to his partner, Henrietta Sykes, 74, by hitting her over the head with the booby prize.
Hey, anything about me in there?
I don't know. Let's see. The girl attacked in the park. Blah, blah, blah. Yes. Well, if you've got a raincoat with a lump torn out of it, you'd better burn it.
That's nothing to do with me. I just wondered if they'd reported me opening the extension at the YWCA.
There's a bit headed here, screams in the night.
This was during the day.
Oh, yes, here we are.
Hey, wait a minute. Show me. Look. That's... Aha. Yeah, this is it. Mr. William Kerr, of no fixed abode, pictured above cutting the tape across the door of the new extension. Mr. Kerr amused the vast crowd by concluding his speech with, and best of luck to all who sail in her.
You didn't use that corny gag, did you?
Yeah.
It's so old. Where did you get it from?
I found it in one of your speeches.
Hello?
What?
See this? Look, in the paper. Grand competition. £250 first prize offered by the town council for new and original statue to be erected in the park. All competitors must have their entries ready for judging within 3 weeks.
Well, what about it?
But that's it. Money in the bank. This is where my LCC plasticine evening classes begin to show a dividend. I thought it was 30 bob down the drain at the time. I only went there because I fancied the model. I'll chip up a quick statue that'll knock their eyes out. Call me secretary in.
Miss Pugh, Griselda, Mr. Hancock wants you.
Tell him to wait. I'm doing some filing.
Well, finish it later.
I can't. I've only done 2 fingers.
Isn't it marvellous? She's been in 3 hours this morning, and what has she done? Washed her hair, had a bath, and painted her toes. She had the phone taken off yesterday. The bell made her jump and upset her jigsaw puzzle. I don't know why I pay her.
Because you're frightened of her?
Exactly. Well, now I'm putting my foot down. Oh, yes. I want some work out of her. Hey, Miss Pugh, Grizzly, come here.
What do you want?
I've got some work for you.
I don't want it. I'm busy enough as it is.
Doing what?
I'm knitting myself a jumper.
Of course. I saw the lorry bringing the wool in this morning. Now, listen here, madam. Work. I've decided to enter for the council statue competition.
You? What do you know about statues?
Quite a lot since I've watched the rate you work at. Hello, there's another one gone home. shafts of wit here. Now, please. There's an entry form in the paper. I want you to fill it in.
Show me. Oh, yes. So, conditions. All entries should be not less than 10 feet high.
What? Show me. Oh, well, let's coalbox that. I'm only 5'6". It's discrimination against the little man. It's not fair.
Look, Henry Moore. The statue has to be 10 feet high.
That's just as bad. Where are we going to find a 10-foot model?
Where are we going to find a 10-foot model? I don't know why you ever left the bush. You'd have been much happier blowing poison darts about. What a stupid remark to make. Where are we going to find a 10-foot model? There's dozens of them about. Any circus will lend us one?
Mr. Hancock, you don't need a 10-foot model. Haven't you ever heard of proportion? All you have to do is get an ordinary-sized model and make the statue twice as big.
Oh, so that's how it's done. So old Nelson wasn't 15 foot tall, huh?
No.
I'm not surprised. When I saw his cabin on the Victory, I thought to myself at the time, I thought he'd have to bend up a bit to get in the hammock there. Oh, well, it's easy now. All we need is the lump of rock, the hammer, the chisel, and we're away. Phone up the quarry and ask him to send down a 20-foot boulder. Then there's just a little job I want you to do.
Oh, you want me to be your model?
No. When it arrives, I want you to carry it through to the back garden.
Hey, how's it going, Tub?
Not very well. I started off by doing horse and rider. I knocked his head off by mistake, so I'm calling it horse now. Oh, well, that's half the leg gone. How does sausage dog sound? No, perhaps not. Miss Pew, phone up for another lump of stone. Let's see. Yes. Oh, that's more like it. It's coming on a treat now.
What is it?
What is it? Isn't it obvious?
No. Some of the bits you chipped off look better than that.
I'll chip a bit off you in a minute. You've got no artistic sense, that's your trouble. No eye for beauty. This is surrealism. It's an abstract composition which I have entitled Olympic Runner.
Well, I hope it's not in our team.
Philistine. This is not only a work of art, it's a triumph of mathematical genius. 2 tons of solid rock, bending forward, depicting the runner leaving the starting block, balanced on his big toe. Took a lot of calculation, just how wide that big toe had to be to support the weight of the statue. Einstein couldn't have worked it out better. Perfectly balanced. You had to blow the dust off his slippers, didn't you? Go on, ring up the quarry and get another lump of rock.
And what's this one supposed to be?
It's a boxer. A heavyweight. One of those. Ring up the quarry and...
It's no good. They haven't got any more. You've had it all.
Well, they can look for some more. There's dozens of hills all over the shop. I must have some stone. What is the point of a chisel if you've got nothing to chis?
Anybody in?
Oh, hello, Sid. Come in.
Hello, Sidney.
Hello, Griselda.
Oh, don't do that, Sidney. You're a naughty boy, Sidney. Why didn't you meet me last night? I waited outside the front of the cinema for 2 hours and you didn't turn up.
The front? Oh, well, that's it. I always get in the exit round the side.
Miss Pew, while you're working for me, I forbid you to have anything to do with this man.
Mind your own business. Uh-oh. Besides, Sidney's given up crime, haven't you, dear?
Have I? Oh, yes, of course I have. I'm as straight as a die now, dead honest. A bona fide, legitimate trader nowadays.
Oh, well, perhaps you know where I can get hold of some carving stone.
Well, by a strange coincidence, that just happens to be the line I'm in. 50 liquor a slab, no questions asked.
Oh, yes, that sounds honest, oh, yes. £50 a slab. The quarry only charged £5 a slab.
Already carved? I can let you have a nice Abraham Lincoln from Parliament Square, only 25 nigger plus freight charges. Of course, there's Charles II from the top of Whitehall. He'll be a bit more expensive because he's on a horse. And you're going to have the Albert Memorial for 30 bob.
Yes. You don't seem to understand. I want untouched slabs of rock so I can carve my own creation. I couldn't enter Abraham Lincoln or Charles II or the Albert Memorial. It wouldn't be right. It would reek of shabby practice. Most unethical. A deliberate flaunting of the artistic code, and besides, they'd recognize them. I want virgin rock or nothing.
All right, and what size do you want?
15 foot tall, 5 foot wide.
Right, I'll have it here first thing in the morning.
By the way, you better get me several slabs. I might make a few mistakes. You know how it is. Go a bit heavy with the old hammer. You've got ear holes lying all over the place.
Yeah, all right, then. Don't worry. I know where I can get all the stone you want. You'll be in plenty of time for the competition.
Here is the news. Early this morning, workmen discovered that a large slab of the parapet of Waterloo Bridge had been removed. Will anybody who can give any information please communicate? Here is a police message. Last night, several more large slabs of stone were removed from Waterloo Bridge, just under the main center arch. Here is the news. Last night, Waterloo Bridge collapsed.
Hey, how's it going, Tub?
Marvelous. Getting on like a house on fire now. Old Sid's worked wonders. He kept me supplied with as much stone as I want. I'm not too happy with the last lot, though. It's covered in mud and seaweed. Still, I... Keep still, Miss Pugh! How can I carve with you flopping about all over the place?
Hey, what's she doing hanging from the ceiling on a pulley?
She's a descended angel. Keep the old trumpet idea. That's right. Stop flapping those wings about. You're not trying to cross the channel.
Well, hurry up. I can't hold this pose much longer.
Oh, stop moaning. It was a mistake using you as a model.
Oh, I don't know. At least you don't have to alter the shape of the rock so much.
Well... We're on the last knockings now. A few more bashes on the old nose here. There we are. Finished. All right, crank her down.
Careful! Careful! Careful!
It's like unloading at the docks, isn't it?
Is the statue ready now?
Yes. Well, what do you think?
Is that supposed to be me? It doesn't look anything like me.
Well, it's got to go up in a public place. We've got to be careful.
It's an insult. Look at it. It's repulsive.
Look, dear, that is how I see you.
It's hideous. My nose isn't as flat as that.
It will be if you don't shut up.
Well, I think it's crude and vulgar. Look, it hasn't got any clothes on. Why didn't you carve my clothes in?
Because I wanted a nude.
Oh, why didn't you ask me then?
Oh, no. Look, dear, be content in the knowledge that you have been connected with a masterpiece. Museums all over the world will be fighting for this. Of course, I've started a new trend, you see. When he sees this, Henry Moore will turn it in and go back to carving door knockers. Now, come on, help me carry it down to the town hall. It's got to be down there ready for judging in the morning. Bill, we're in trouble. Sid has been at it.
What, have they thrown your statue out already?
No, they don't see him till this morning. But I've had a quick look under the sheets at the other entrance.
Oh, why, what's wrong?
There's an Abraham Lincoln, a Charles II, and the top of the Albert Memorial.
Well, you won't stand a chance against them.
I'm not worried about the quality. I can show them the way home any day. It's the size that bothers me. They're all bigger than mine, and that's fatal. In this country, they don't worry about how good it is, it's how big it is. You can get away with murder if it's the right size.
Oh, so what are you going to do? Put a hat on it? Hey, how about a nice busby? That'd give you a few extra feet.
A busby. Look just right on a descending angel, wouldn't it? Poltroon. What I need is a big pedestal. I haven't got time to make one. We've got to get hold of one from somewhere. Look, ring up Sid and see what he can do.
Here is the news. During the night, thieves removed Nelson's column from Trafalgar Square. Latest reports to come in say that the actual statue of Nelson was later found lying in the back of Boadicea's chariot on the embankment. The column is still missing. It is believed to be the work of Scottish nationalists. All ports and aerodromes are being watched. MI5.
Hey, Warren Cook, here's your pedestal. What do you think of it?
Marvellous, Sid. 120-foot high pedestal, that's the style. Bigger than any of them now. I'll have to go up by helicopter to judge my statue. You've been a great help, Sid. It was 50 for the pedestal, wasn't it?
That's right. Here, you wouldn't like three or four lions to shove around the bottom of it, would you?
No, I don't think so. Bit ostentatious?
Yeah, perhaps.
Besides, people might think I'm cribbing that one in Trafalgar Square.
Yeah, and we wouldn't want that, would we?
No.
Oh, well, Tanner, any time you want anything, you get in touch.
Now, don't go wasted. Sid, stay and wait for the results. They'll be through any minute now. Quiet now, here's his wash up the Mur.
Ladies and gentlemen, I now have great pleasure in announcing the results of our competition for the new statue to be erected in the park. My colleagues and I are unanimous in awarding the first prize to Mr. Anthony Hancock's brilliant composition, Barrage Balloon on the End of a Thick Cable.
Miller! It's descending angel...
It's descending angel on a pedestal.
Oh, well, anyway, it's big and we like it. Second was Charles II and third, Abraham Lincoln. The unveiling ceremony will take place in the park on Saturday afternoon, together with the presentation of the check.
Oh, Bert Lodge's improved on the floor. I can remember when he didn't know which end to put in his mouth.
Hello, he's still got it wrong.
No wonder they made in the town car, the mouth that's on.
Don't you feel nervous, Tup, sitting up here on the platform with all these civic dignitaries?
Of course not. I'm a match for this lot any day. I think I look rather resplendent myself. The old collapsible top hat, the celluloid dickie, striped trousers and spats, what? They don't often see a gent like me down these parts. Right rural lot we've got up here, you know. All smocks and shepherd's crooks, look at them. I think they're very impressed with me.
I can't think why. You look like one of those cannibal chiefs. What's the red sash with a gold star on it?
I'm not sure. The bloke in the junk shop said it was the Legion of Honour. Legion d'honneur, you know. Fluent Polish, of course.
It's about time for the ceremony to start, isn't it?
Any minute now. Here he goes. The mayor's getting up now. Go on, Mush.
One, two, three, four. Testing.
The local butcher, you know.
Friends, fellow citizens. Today is a very important landmark in the cultural development of our community.
Get on with it.
Yes. Do you mind? As you know, we have lagged sadly behind other boroughs in our appreciation of the arts.
When are you going to repair the slipper bars? Let him get on with it. You never use them.
Thank you. So we, as a committee, decided that something must be done to remedy this sad state of affairs. The question was, what?
We're going to repair the slipper bar.
Yes. And so we decided to sponsor a competition for our local sculptors to design a statue to grace our fair park.
And what about the drains in River Road?
Yes, thank you. Quiet, please. The competition has been held, and today I will have great pleasure in presenting the check to the winner, a loyal citizen who has been a stalwart member of our community for many years and has been a great champion of the betterment of our cultural education in the borough. You may remember his other works of art.
They smell!
What do?
The drains in River Road!
Please give the mayor a fair hearing. The mayor a fair hearing.
Thank you.
Give him a chance. Give him a chance.
Thank you very much.
Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. The winner I am referring to is, of course, the great sculptor, Mr. Anthony Hancock, R.A.
R.A.?
Royal Artillery, they don't know.
But then you didn't come here to listen to me.
Yes,
thank you. And so I will conclude.
Well done. Can I have the check now, please?
And wait till it's unveiled. I will now call upon my good lady wife, the mayoress, to perform the unveiling ceremony.
Good old Sir Lonely, take them off, girl.
To be here today to unveil this work of art. And so I now declare the statue unveiled.
Good health, can I have the check?
Not yet. Go on, my dear, pull the string.
Oh, yes.
Thank you. I now call upon Mr. Hancock to say a few words.
Thank you. Can I have the check now?
Well, here, say something else.
Oh, all right. Yes. My friends. In the red corner. No. My friends. Thank you for your kind response to my statue.
Oh, wait.
Yes.
It's obscene.
He means it's filthy.
It shouldn't be. It's had a cover over it all night. It's the smog, sir. It happens all the time. My car's just the same. It's gone green.
Hey, it's disgusting.
It's in the nude.
Well, so would you be if you didn't have any clothes on. What sort of a criticism is this?
It's the threat to the respectable women of this borough.
Some of the slipper bobs.
I protest. How can a work of art be indecent? They said Rubens' pictures were indecent. Mind you, I grant you they were a bit racy. Please, let's not be narrow-minded. Let's have a larger vision. She's wearing a sight more than some of those bits they get on television.
I say it ought to be Tabitha.
I admit she's not wearing much, but what she's got is in the right places. I want fairly and squarely, and I want my £250.
Stomp, stomp, stomp. Don't give him the cheque.
Who are you?
I'm the chairman of the local watch committee.
Well, mine's stopped. Have it ready by Thursday.
No, stop messing about. It's my job to protect the public's morals. No statue can be erected in this town till I've passed it. Now, let's have a look at it. Yes, well, that bit'll have to be covered up for a start.
I refuse to touch it. It stays as it is.
We can't. It's naughty.
It's a perfectly respectable statue. What right have you got to poke your nose in?
It's my job. I'm the local censor. I have to go around looking at all the things that the public shouldn't be allowed to see. Good enough, good.
I bet it is.
Do you know, I've seen some films that make your hair curl.
Get away.
Of course, you won't see them. Not unless you come round to my house.
Well, what's round there, then?
Well, you see, all the bits of film I order to be cut out...
Yes, yes, yes.
I put them in my pocket, stick them together and make one big film out of them. It's smashing. The plot's not very good, but cool.
You're a bit of a boy, aren't you?
Oh, well, I have my moments.
What about the statue?
Shut up! You were saying...
Well, you know that film with Martine Carroll in it?
Where she's taking the bath and the ass's milk.
That's it.
Yes.
And then,
yes.
Just as she started to get out, the scene ended.
Yes.
Well, it didn't. Look.
Dear, oh dear, oh dear.
Oh, I got pockets full here. Well, it passes an hour, doesn't it?
Are these all from films?
No, the best ones I took myself.
Where?
I'm not going to tell you.
What about the slipper bobs?
How did he know?
Well, I must say I'm very pleased to know that the borough's moral welfare is in your hands, even though they are shaken a bit.
Well, thank you.
Tell me, you're a man of the world now. What about this competition of my statue?
Well, under the circumstances...
Yes?
I mean, seeing what's passed between us...
Go on, yes.
And
yes.
Bearing in mind the spirit of the artistic development of our beloved borough...
Of course.
I order it to be destroyed.
I protest. I've already won it. You can't do this to me. What about the money?
I'll tell you what we'll do. You can have the money if you guarantee to do another statue. Do a nice one.
Oh, very well. William, ring up Sid James and order some more stone. I'll do a family group this time, paddling in a slipper bath.
There we are, Hancock. 6 chunks of stone, 16 foot high, 100 nicker.
Thank you, Sid. I don't know what I'd do without you.
All right. Don't move. Stay where you are. So we've caught up with you at last, eh?
I beg your pardon?
First Waterloo Bridge, then Charles II. Abraham Lincoln, you also remove Nelson's column. And now, this. I think you'd better come along with me. The court is now in session.
Object! I'm innocent, Your Honor. I had no idea it was Stonehenge. Only 6 lumps of rock. I didn't touch them. They're still in good nick. You can get a bit of cement and put them back, can't you?
Silence in court. We're going to make an example of you.
You can't do this to me. I'll make a bargain. I'll carve you something. For the roof. How about a woman in a blindfold holding a pair of scales up? That'll look good.
Silence. The court will rise to pass.
There. That's that one finished.
Here, Hancock, is another chunk of stone for you.
How many more, Sid?
One more lorry load, then we're on the mailbags. Come on, hurry up, get that ticket. The porter's watching.